Hello friends, I'm back with a new video, and this time we are going to discuss a very important chapter, that is geography, for this CDS examination. Compared to past three CDS examination, nowadays if you compare CAPF examination, geography questions were asked more. So I'm going to give you some important topics to revise for the upcoming CDS examination, and I hope it will be very helpful. Please take your notes, pen, everything, and get ready for important notes. Before going on to the video, here I would like to say that Bangalore Defence Academy is going to keep a free combined defence service examination revision classes completely for 2 days. Especially for 2 days, friends. And this is on the weekends, that is on Jan 25 and Jan 26. We have selected these days because on Saturday and Sunday, people are on week off. They have a government holiday. So I request you all candidates, those who are watching this video, could spread this news for all your friends, those who are preparing for this CDS examination. There will be 2 days free revision of all the subjects and with all the current affairs to be expected in the upcoming CDS examination. You can register with your name. We can just type to this number 7598486430, and this is our address. Candidate, those who are from other cities, we have a lot of PG here, hostel facilities here. You can just come and visit for 2 days. You can just WhatsApp this number, and quickly we'll go on to the slides. Geography. Yes, friends, geography is a very important subject when it comes to combined defense service examination. Geography is divided into two, that is world geography and Indian geography when it comes to this examination. Indian geography, we have rivers, then lakes, then mountains, then plateaus, then coastal areas, then deserts. All these things are in detail. Then economic geography, that is how the people survive, their occupation, all these things. Then we have soil as a chapter, like what are the types of soil. Then we have crops as a chapter. Okay, we are going to give an idea of how to revise these chapters one by one. Then comes your world geography. World geography, the basic thing you already know, the continents, the major plates, minor plates. Then you have drift theory. Then you have, for example, the ocean currents. What are the ocean currents? What happens with them? And then you have what we say El Nino and La Nina, all those things. Just a minute, friends. Okay. So now, today I'm going to give an importance, like first point you should keep in mind, you have to do little map work. Now, for example, past some days, Iran is in news that it has gunned down a passenger aircraft from Ukraine. So immediately you have to take map, find out the location of this Iran, what's the capital like Tehran, and then what is the relation between Iran and India in so and so way that you are going to prepare for this. Map work is very, very important. Then when it comes to the next topic, you have to focus on ocean current. Definitely there will be a question on ocean current. And ocean current, suppose if you take Pacific Ocean, I'm just giving you an example. Pacific Ocean. Pacific Ocean has warm ocean current and you have cold ocean current. So what are the examples of warm ocean current? You have to by heart it. What are the examples of cold ocean current? You have to by heart it. Then you have Atlantic Ocean. Then you have Indian Ocean. Okay. Then when ocean current chapter is over, then you have to come up with an idea like what is mean by El Nino. What is mean by El Nino and its effects on monsoon and its effects on monsoon in India. So this is how we are going to give a direction for it. After coming, I'll give you a rough idea when I'm dealing with the chapters. So now let us go to our next slide, that is Indian geography. Indian geography, what to do? I'll just give you a small, I'll just draw a map. You please try to imagine, suppose if this is India here, okay? This is just a rough map, okay? Please bear with me. Fine. Now, Tropic of Cancer passes through India here, that is 23.5 degrees north. This is Tropic of Cancer. When it comes to Tropic of Cancer, how many Indian states passes through Tropic of Cancer? East to west, west to east. And in the world, how many countries passes through equator from west to east and east to west? Then you have Tropic of Capricorn and then you have Tropic of Cancer. One favorite question is like, which of the South American nation on like both equator and Tropic of Capricorn process. Answer is Brazil. Okay. Now, some months back, 6 months back, Amazon forest was in fire, and today it is Australian bushfire. Australian bushfire. So they are going to ask you some questions on forest or what is meant by disaster management, some kind of questions like this. Be prepared for it. Coming to Indian geography, first we are going to talk about rivers. Here there is Lake Manasarovar. Rivers are divided into two, mainly like three, that is North Indian River, Central Indian River, and Southern Indian River. North Indian River mainly, that is Ganga, Yamuna, and then you have other tributaries, you have Brahmaputra and Indus. Central rivers, namely, you will call it as Narmada, Tapi, Mahanadi. Okay, Narmada, Tapi, Mahanadi. And southern rivers, you have Godavari, then you have Krishna, then you have Kaveri. Okay, and there are plenty of other small rivers that this video is only to give you an idea how to revise for the upcoming CDS examination. We don't have much time to exactly explain what is the river Ganga, what are the prayags and all, but still we'll try to do maximum. Fine, friends. Now we'll just see first the North Indian rivers. Here there is Lake Manasarovar, and from this Lake Manasarovar, a river is coming like this, and here this is a point called as Namcha Barwa. Namcha Barwa. From this Namcha Barwa point, this river Zangpo, in Tibet it is called as Zangpo. This river enters India and then it flows to West Bengal, and now it is called as Brahmaputra. Now, when it comes to any river, you have to find out what are the left bank tributaries and right bank tributaries of each rivers. The left bank tributaries and the right bank tributaries of each river. Then important dams on it, important dams on it, and important cities on it, the activities. And nowadays the government of India is focusing on national waterway. So you have to find out what is national waterway 1, what is national waterway 2, what is national waterway 3, and so on. Okay, Allahabad to Haldia is national waterway 1. So in this way you have to focus on rivers waterway like that. Now coming to another river, that is from this Lake Manasarovar, river flows like this, and this river in Tibet it is called as Singi Kambam. It is called as Singi Kambam, and here this river is called as Indus. Indus. Now what are the tributaries of Indus? The tributaries of Indus are Chambal, Son, Betwa, King. Okay, Chambal is there. Then sorry, I'm sorry, that is the tributaries of Yamuna. You have Chenab. Okay, you have Jhelum. Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias, and Satluj. Bias and Satluj. These are the five important tributaries of river Indus. So, for example, this is Jhelum, this is Chenab, this is Ravi, this is Bias, this is Satluj. Now, when it comes to Jhelum, last time in NDA examination conducted by UPSC, they have asked an exam question, examination question, like which river name, the ancient name is Vitasta. Which river name is Vitasta? So here the answer is Jhelum. So what happens if you see the North Indian rivers, they have some ancient name, you have to focus on it. Okay, so now coming to the next river from the same Lake Manasarovar, this river Satluj flows from here. There is a river that is Satluj. Okay, friends. Now after this, if you come to the Central Indian rivers, here there is a plateau called as Amarkantak Plateau. A river is flowing here, Narmada. Then down from Betul, there is Tapi, and from one more river, that is Mahanadi, and then from Amarkantak, there is one more river that is Son. Okay, so they may ask you how many rivers flows from Amarkantak Plateau. Okay, like Central Indian rivers, you have to focus on it. Then you have Ganga, the left bank tributaries, right bank tributaries. Each river has left bank tributaries and right bank tributaries. Coming to the southern Indian rivers, Godavari is called as Dakshin Ganga. The tributaries of Godavari, then Krishna, then Kaveri, the important dams on it. This is how you are going to focus on it. Now, coming to very important topic, like what are the expected questions on rivers? We know what are the rivers, in which direction it is flowing, something like that. Friends, if you are preparing for Group X, Group Y, or Navy SSR exams, if you are preparing for Navy SSR exam or any other government exam like SSC, CGL, or etc., they are going to ask you which river is called as Sorrow of Bihar. Answer is Kosi. Which river is called as Sorrow of the Bengal? That is answer is Damodar. Okay, and Sorrow of Orissa is Mahanadi. Sorrow of Orissa is Mahanadi. Now, if this is like this examination question, now in UPSC they will ask you, in which river do you find India's only river island? India's only river island. The answer is, it is found on river Brahmaputra. Some years back it was in news due to the flood, Brahmaputra. And the island name is Majuli. The island name is Majuli. So now, Brahmaputra is very important because it flows through a forest, that is Kaziranga National Park. Okay, Kaziranga National Park. Now, what is famous in Kaziranga National Park? Single horned rhinoceros. Okay, these animals are protected in Wildlife Protection Act under schedule number 1 to 5. Okay, that is all like your CAPF examination syllabus. Okay, now one thing you have to focus, tributaries, left bank, right bank, the old name of the rivers. Okay, the old names of the rivers, and the third one is the important dams on it and cities and cities. So these are the core areas where UPSC is going to ask you some questions. These are the core areas where you have to focus. Going to the next topic, lakes and plains. Okay, what are the important lakes which you know? What are the important lakes? You might have heard there is something called as Loktak Lake, then there is something called a Chilka Lake, then you have something called as Sambar Lake. Now we'll see one by one. Okay friends, now in Manipur you have Loktak Lake, in Orissa you have Chilka Lake, then here in Andhra you have Pulikat Lake. These are all important big lakes which I'm telling. There are plenty of lakes. Then you have Kerala, you have Vembanad Lake, and then in Rajasthan you have Sambar Lake. In Rajasthan you have Sambar Lake and Dal and Buller Lake in Jammu Kashmir. Dal and Buller Lake in Jammu Kashmir. So these are the lakes. Now when it comes to plain, okay, this is like this northern part about Tropic of Cancer, and down it is southern. Here we have Bundelkhand, we have Bagelkhand and Chota Nagpur Plateau, and this is Deccan Plateau town. Deccan Plateau continues till these three hills. This is where candidates do mistake, and these three hills are Garo, then you have Khasi, and then you have Jaintia. Garo, Khasi and Jaintia. Now this Deccan Plateau, here it is covered by Western Ghats. Okay, here it is covered by Western Ghat, then here you have Eastern Ghat, then you have Javadi, Nalamala, Shevroy, all these mountains. Here you have Aravallis and Vindhyas. These are all mountain regions. Okay friends, now going to the coast and deserts. Coastal areas are very important, and we have important 13 major ports in Indian coastal areas. So those who are preparing for Navy exams, or those who have cracked INET, and those who go for SSB, you already know that they ask questions on important ports and what it is. Okay, please bear with me. Here you have some coastal area. This is called as Eastern Coast, and here this is called as Western Coast. Eastern Coast is divided into two. This part is called as Coromandel. This called is part as Coromandel, and this part is called as Northern Sirkar. This part is called as Northern Sirkar. This is Western Coast. This is divided as two, that is Malabar, and this is divided, and this is called as Konkan. This is called as Konkan. Okay, further it is divided into two, that you have to go and check it in your NCRT. That is, they don't ask much, but still. Now coming to the ports, here you have Kolkata, then Paradip, then Vishakhapatnam, then Kakinada is there, then Chennai is there, Tuticorin is there, down Kanyakumari, then you have Cochin, then you have Mangalore, then you are in Goa near Panaji, and then you have Bombay, and then you have Surat. These are all the important ports in this. Deserts. This is Rajasthan desert, and here you have Leh and Ladakh desert. Going to next, world geography. What are the expected questions on world geography? As I told you, ocean geography. Then types of landforms. Types of landforms. What does it mean? Suppose if I draw this volcanic mountain. Okay. Suppose if I draw this volcanic mountain. Okay. And this is, imagine, a volcano. Okay. Suppose if this is volcano. Now this is called as vent. This pipe is opening is called as vent, and the magma may come out from here. What happens when the magma is coming out? The volcanic mountain grows. But sometimes this volcano gets solidifies. This volcano gets solidifies. So here this forms a type of lith or a rock. Now here you have batholith, then you have lapholith, then you have something called as gills, then you have something called as dikes. What are this? This is how they are going to ask them, match the following from the different landforms. Now you have running water. Okay, you have running water. Running water has two types, erosional features and depositional features. Erosional features you have caves, depositional features you have deltas. Now caves we call it as karst topography. We call it as karst topography. What is my karst topography? I'll draw it here. Suppose if this is cave, okay, here you can find some ice cubes like this. Okay, it is like this. Okay, so this is called like karst topography. What happens? This is called as stalactites. This is called as stalactites, and this is called as stalagmites, and this is called as pillars. This is called as pillars. So if you take the previous year CDS question paper, most of the questions are repeated from this karst topography. Okay, they are repeated from this karst topography. So you have to be careful on this. So like this, you have something called as wind. What happens in wind? Erosional features and depositional features. Here erosional features is like cave, then depositional features you have something called as dunes, and in dunes you have barkans. Okay, then you have different kind of dunes and something like that. Okay, this is there. Then you have something called as glaciers. Okay, then you have something called as glaciers, and glaciers also have erosional and depositional features. There are many things. Okay, now after this you have to keep in mind the economic geography of the world. Economic, for example, where do you find iron ore more in the world, or zinc or copper, or this kind of questions will be asked in your world geography. Not to dive in deep in world geography, if you know the, and yeah, definitely you should know the number of countries passing through equator. Then you have Capricorn, and then you have Cancer. Okay, then you have Cancer, Tropic of Cancer. This you should know. And ocean current. Okay, ocean current. If this is there, this is more than enough. You can proceed with other topic. Okay, friends. So now, this was a small revision for you all for geography. Still, if you have any doubt, you can comment in our comment section. And please do keep in mind that we are having revision classes on 25th and 26th of Jan. 25th and 26th of Jan 2020. Okay, 2020, that is on Saturday and Sunday. Candidates are registering, plenty of messages are flooding. And so you please do keep in mind there is limited seats here. So we don't have that much amount of space to occupy 200 or 300 candidates. There is limited seats here, and classes will be going on from morning to night. Okay, till you get the hold of the subject. And the best part is, like, you will be getting the idea of all the current affairs which will be asked in the examinations. Like, for example, sports and awards, the person who died in recently in the past year. Okay, something like that. The important schemes which may be asked. Okay, like that. We are from Bangalore Defence Academy, and we are giving coaching for National Defence Academy, Combined Defence Service, AFCAT, INET, Group X, Group 5, and all other examinations. Candidate, those who are preparing for all this examination, I request you all the best, and please do subscribe our channel, and please do keep in touch with us. Any doubt you have, we are ready to help you. I am Arun Kumar making this video. If you have any other doubt on any other topic, you can please message us. We'll make video on that particular chapter also. Jai Hind, see you next time.